Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Thanks for clicking on this video. As you can tell, we're going to be going over the monthly dividend company today, Realty Income. If you do like my content, please consider liking and subscribing as it helps the channel tremendously. Without further ado, let's hop right in. Now let's take a look at the company. So Realty Income is known as the monthly dividend company. They are an S&P 500 company dedicated to providing stockholders with dependable monthly income. Their monthly dividends are supported by the cash flow from their property portfolio. Over the past 52 years, Realty Income has been acquiring and managing freestanding commercial properties that generate rental revenue under long-term net lease agreements. So now let's take a look at Realty Income's track record. So in 1969, they were founded by William and Joan Clark. In 1994, they began trading on the NYSE under the famous ticker symbol O. So in 07, they were added to the S&P MidCap Index. In 2011, they completed $1 billion in annual property acquisitions. In 2014, they surpassed $3 billion in common stock dividends paid to shareholders. 2015, they were added to the legendary S&P 500 Index. And recently in 2020, they were added to the S&P 500 Dividend Aristocrats Index. Now let's take a look at Realty Income's price movement. So on Friday, they were up 0.4%, over the week up 1%, for the month they were up 1.62%, over 6 months up 18.6%, for the year up 20.64%, 5 years they were actually down 0.4%, however over 10 years they were up 104%. Now let's take a look at the investor presentation for May of 2021. This slide shows where Realty Income is right now and what their future goals are. So right now they're an S&P 500 company, one of 65 companies in the elite S&P 500 Dividend Aristocrats Index. So they're one of 65 out of 500 companies that pay a dividend which increases annually. They're a top 10 global REIT, 15.2% compound annual total shareholder return since public listing in 1994, and 4.4% compound annual dividend growth rate since 1994, and 110 dividend increases. In their future, they hope to become a $50 billion global company as measured by enterprise value. They hope to consolidate $12 trillion in the global net lease addressable market. They want to go from a top 10 global REIT to a top 5 global REIT. They want to average double-digit total shareholder return with minimal volatility, and they want to continue treating their dividend as a sacrosanct to their DNA. So the company's investment thesis includes four things: a proven track record of their returns, stability and growth of their earnings, their consistent and increasing dividend, and their future in the REIT industry. Realty Income takes a lot of pride in its risk to reward, risk being beta and reward being return. The average beta for the S&P 500 is around 1, and the average return is around 12%. Realty Income has a return of 15.2% and a beta of 0.4, having higher returns with less volatility, putting it in the top 95 percentile of all S&P 500 companies. And we're comparing it to its S&P 500 REIT peers as a top 3 risk-to-reward ratio. 1 of 7 net lease REITs, 1 of 15 S&P 500 REITs, and 1 of 6 retail REITs increased their dividend in 2020. Realty Income was one of them, as they increased their dividend by 3.1%. However, only around 50% of those companies had positive earnings growth in 2020, which shows that Realty Income can pay dividends without incurring too much debt. Realty Income uses a very different and efficient system compared to shopping centers and malls. They use a unique net lease structure that drives lower cash flow volatility. Realty Income presents various advantages. Initial length of lease is over 15 years, while for malls it's less than 10. Remaining average term is around 9 years, 5 to 7 for malls. Responsibility for property expenses is on the client, however for malls it's on the landlord. Gross margin is over 98%, for malls around only 75%. Volatility of rental revenue is low, modest and high for shopping center and malls. Low to modest and high again. Reliance on anchor tenants is none. Shopping centers and malls is high. Average retail property size, 12K square feet. Shopping center and malls, 150K to 850K. Obviously, your average mall will be bigger than your average CVS or Walgreens. When it comes to target markets, Realty Income has many, while shopping centers have few. External acquisition opportunities, high, low for malls. And then finally, institutional buyer competition, modest for Realty Income, high for shopping centers and malls.
Realty Income has a diversified portfolio with many different high-quality companies. Their biggest client is Walgreens at 5.5%, followed by 7-Eleven at 4.6%, then Dollar General at 4.3%, FedEx at 3.6%, Dollar Tree and Family Dollar at 3.2%, Sainsbury at 3.1%, LA Fitness at 3%, AMC Theaters at 2.8%, Regal Theaters at 2.6%, Walmart and Sam's Club at 2.6%, Lifetime Fitness at 2.3%, Circle K at 1.7%, BJ's at 1.6%, Speedway at 1.6%, Treasury Wine Estates at 1.5%, CVS Pharmacy at 1.5%, and then Home Depot, Kroger, B&Q, and Tesco all at 1.4%. When it comes to industry diversification of those companies, 12% are from convenience stores, 10% grocery stores, 7.9% drug stores, 7.4% dollar stores, 6.4% health, 5.6% theaters, 5.2% fast food restaurants, 4.5% home improvement, 3.9% transportation services, and then finally 3.5% general merchandise. When it comes to property type, 1.6% are agriculture, 3% is office, 11.5% is industrial, and 84% is retail. Finally, geographic diversification, 10.4% of clients are from Texas, 8.8% from California, 7.2% from the United Kingdom, 5.7% from Illinois, and 5.1% from Florida. Realty Income has never had occupancy under 96%, meaning their rental space is being rented out by companies almost always. As their portfolio occupancy stays the same, they continue to add more total properties every year, all the way up to 6,662 for Q1 of 2021. Realty Income grows their earnings by increasing the size of their real estate portfolio and increasing rent on their existing leases. They use this existing cash flow to buy more properties, which ends up resulting in more cash flow and more properties. This endless cycle results in a continued success in revenue, earnings, and dividend payments. Now let's take a look at the dividend summary. The monthly dividend company has a current yield of 4.06%, which translates to a $2.83 per share annual payout. The payout ratio is 83%, the 5-year growth rate is 3.79%, and the dividend growth is 24 years straight. Well, that's all I've got for today. I hope you enjoyed the video and learned something new. Make sure to hit the like button to help out with the YouTube algorithm. Also, make sure to subscribe to keep up with all my uploads. Quick reminder to check the description below for additional resources related to finance, investing, and YouTube. Enough said, have a great day, and thanks for watching and stopping by. I'll see you in the next one. Chokey beep.